Now, tourists continue to flock to Albay province to catch the display of nature's might from Mayon volcano. This despite Mayon's possible eruption. Our correspondent Irene Perol joins us with that story. Good afternoon, Irene. Thanks a lot for your updates. What can you tell us so far?
Stanley, the Department of Tourism Office in Bicol clarifies, government is not stopping tourists from seeing Mayon volcano despite its possible eruption. Instead, the different local government units around Mayon volcano have designated locations where tourists can safely observe Mayon's activities. DOT Bicol Regional Director Herbie Agua says, only isolated areas are affected by the volcanic activities of Mayon, and there are a lot of things to enjoy in Albay, like the food and beaches. Some of the tourist destinations and activities, though, are limited due to Mayon's festiveness, like the Mayon skyline and ATV rides. Mayon skyline and its neighboring establishments in Buang Tabaco City, which is situated inside the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone, are closed to the public for now. ATV rides and mountaineering and hiking activities inside the 6-kilometer radius are also strictly prohibited. The DOT guarantees it is prepared to help any stranded tourists in the province in case the situation gets worse. Meanwhile, Bicol International Airport in Daragalpay is still on normal operations. BIA management says it has increased its inspection on the runways to check for possible contaminants like ash fall, which may affect flights. They are also consistently posting updates on their social media sites to keep passengers updated of the airport's operations. Stanley?
Okay, Irene, you mentioned some activities are not allowed at this time because of the danger, particularly those within the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone. Let's walk through some of the famous or more popular tourist destinations, specifically Cagsawa, for instance. Are tourists still allowed there?
Yes, Cagsawa Ruins is still allowed. It's outside the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone. In fact, just today, the DOT has released already a list of places where they can visit. This list actually includes also like how far is it from the crater of the Mayon volcano. So I see some of these are like in Legazpi, they have the Sawangan Park, the Legazpi Highlight, in Daraga, the Cagsawa Ruins Park, Farm Plate, Daraga Church, and then the National Museum. So they made this list so that the tourists will know where to go. But just this morning, we are now at the foot of the volcano on the Buang side, no, in Tabaco City, the Mayon skyline, which is the little baguio of Albay. And according to the police who are manning the site, no, there are still tourists who wanted to go up the Mayon skyline, the planetarium, and this is one of the sites which is actually prohibited by the provincial government and by the PDRRMO, Stanley.
Okay, a while ago you were talking about some sites, specific viewing points per municipality around the volcano. As an insider, as a local, which vantage point can you suggest where one can get the best viewing of Mayon volcano, whether it's daytime or nighttime?
Where we had our live point last night in Legazpi Highlands is one of the beautiful sites. But if they're also staying in the hotels, so in Legazpi City, almost all the hotels have, you know, viewing sites at their roof decks. So they can do that at the comfort of the hotels where they are staying.
Okay. Lastly, Irene, what advice have you gotten from our airport officials? You were saying they're monitoring closely the situation in Mayon and how it will affect airports. In any case, is there a diversionary route that may affect at least the on-time performance of a lot of flights, considering these planes need to travel a little farther away from the volcano to land?
Yes. The nearest airport, if in case flights are canceled in Bicol International Airport in Daragalpay, the nearest airport will be in Naga City or the Pili Airport in Camarines Sur. Although there are limited flights in that area because the airport is smaller as compared to the one in Albay.
Okay, on that note, we thank you so much for the updates and insights, Irene Perol. Thanks for your report. State volcanologists keeping a close watch on the new lava dome that has formed on Mayon's crater. This as the volcano undergoes a slow, extrusive eruption. More in this report.
Mayon volcano has been covered in thick clouds for several days. Though it may appear to have fallen silent, the instruments of FEVOX say otherwise. From 95, the number of rockfall events has increased to 177. The amount of sulfur emissions has also increased from 417 to 1,205 tons. FEVOX says there is an ongoing slow extrusive eruption on Mayon. This means the volcano is slowly spewing out volcanic materials like lava and rocks. But state volcanologists are not ruling out an explosive eruption.
Na pwedeng mag-escalate to a more explosive type of eruption. Kaya pinaalis yung mga tao doon sa danger zone. Yung mga rockfall na nangyayari ay nag-generate ng mga PDC, pyroclastic density current.
The extrusive eruption is the reason why a new lava dome has formed on Mayon Volcano's crater.
Yung implication po nito is, kumbaga, nabalatan na yung dating, or natanggal na po yung dating lava dome and na-reveal na po sa ilalim yung mas fluidal na tawag namin. Kung yung nasa taas po ay parang matigas na po, bato-bato na, yun nga, nag-generate ng rockfall, ito po, possibly, dyan na po magsimula yung lava flow na alam natin. Magdaloy na, mas free na po yung pagdaloy niya.
Around 7 p.m. Sunday, lava began to flow down Mayon towards the Bonga and Maise gullies. FEVOX earlier said there can be lava flow anytime as the extrusive eruption continues. The agency does not yet have a volume estimate on the size of the new lava dome. Meanwhile, the evacuation of residents continues. In Ginubatan, Albay, 800 families have been relocated to the Mauraro Evacuation Center. Residents still complaining of the heat and lack of water.
Mahirap sa ano, wala kaming yung sa tubig, yung ihian.
Mainit daw talaga yun ang number one na reklamo nila. So siguro mag-provide na lang kami sa LGU ng some electric fans and kung anong kailangan nila.
Ginubatan's mayor is also dismayed that some are taking advantage of the calamity to run scams. The mayor says he received a call from someone pretending to be a high official.
And nag-promise siya, papadalhan kami ng 1,200 sacks ng bigas, but inihingian kami ng panggasolin, tracking, papunta dito sa aming bayan. So, doon, nagduda ako.
The Social Welfare Department has distributed food packs to affected residents.
The next 15 days, we projected their food requirements already. That's around 38,000 food boxes. The game plan there is, after 15 days, the provincial government will do the next 6 days of food relay. Nice. And then after which, the national government will come in again for another 15 days. That will take us close to 45 days, which is the minimum from experience before.
Albay bracing for the possibility the alert level of Mayon volcano could be raised from 3 to 4 today due to that new lava dome. According to FEVOX, the new dome is filled with gas which can cause steam to build up and eventually result in an explosive activity. Meanwhile, over 13,000 individuals living within the volcano's 6-kilometer permanent danger zone have already been evacuated. But this could increase if Mayon's alert level escalates.
We actually base our actions on the reports of FEVOX. And as I've said earlier, what will happen, what the possibility of actually increasing the radius would coincide with the FEVOX advisory. For example, if the FEVOX tells us to actually raise the same to alert level 4, then the radius would increase from 6 to 7 kilometers. This would mean more evacuees need to be evacuated.
The health department gives its assurance hospitals and medical teams in the Bicol region are ready to respond to any emergency situation amid Mayon's restiveness. Health Secretary Ted Herbosa says they have already sent medicines as well as hydration and sanitation kits to Albay. The agency also monitoring evacuation centers to prevent the spread of diseases. Herbosa says they continue to coordinate with government agencies in the region.
We'll deploy a medical response team to the affected areas. So sinabi ko, magkaroon tayo ng adequate water, sanitation, and hygiene commodities para sa mga nandoon sa evacuation center. Ibig sabihin nun, additional portable toilets, additional water for bathing, and sanitary things. Nag-inventory din sila ng kanilang mga warehouses sa Bicol at nandoon nakastock yung kanilang mga supplies.
Let's get an update now on the situation near Mayon Volcano. Jose Carretero joins us for that. Jose, over to you.
Hi, Sandy. The Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology is closely monitoring the activity of Mayon Volcano. For the past 24 hours, VVOCS recorded 21 volcanic earthquakes, 270 rockfall events, and 3 pyroclastic density currents. These parameters are higher compared to the previous monitoring. Meanwhile, lava flow from Mayon Volcano Summit has already commenced Sunday night. It started to flow at 7:47 p.m. The lava is flowing at Bunga and Misi Igalis, reaching 500 meters. Mayon Volcano Observatory resident volcanologist Dr. Paul Alani said the lava flow means that 2018 lava dome is gone and newer, more fluidic lava is coming out of the volcano. Mayon Volcano remains at alert level 3. Meanwhile, Stanley, some 3,761 families or 13,348 individuals have already been evacuated according to Albay Public Safety and Emergency Management Office or APSIMO. The target families to be evacuated is 4,000 plus or more than 14,000 individuals. However, APSIMO said they have already reached 88% of the 100% target. APSIMO OIC head Eugene Escobar said the evacuation efforts of the province for the residents inside the 6 kilometers permanent danger zone have stopped already. Those who still refuse to evacuate will be handled by their respective LGUs. The provincial government of Albay has issued today preparedness status in anticipation of possible raising of alert level 4. Residents inside the 7-kilometer extended danger zone are advised to prepare to evacuate should alert level be raised. Stanley.
Okay, Jose, you're saying it will be raised to alert level 4. What is the process? Is there going to be a meeting or a session before this happens anytime today?
Stanley, the raising of alert level will be done by FEVOC, so they're still studying all the parameters that may lead to raising the alert level.
Okay, let's talk about the evacuation centers now. Earlier, we aired reports there were complaints about water supply and water quality in the evacuation centers. Is anything being done about this now?
I've talked to some mayors who are in charge of the evacuees. They said they're doing their best to address the problem. The Office of Civil Defense on its part, Stanley, has promised it will send to Albay water filtration units to ensure clean water also. Aside from water supply, Stanley, some are also complaining of unfavorable temperature inside the modular tent, especially during noontime. Stanley.
Okay, Jose, you've been covering Mayon Volcano for so many years now. I mean, you've witnessed a lot of these episodes there and the evacuation situation. If this prolongs, as in some cases they do, how does government intend to sustain the people at the evacuation centers?
Actually, sadly, the provincial government of Albay said that their funds will, like they have the 30 million quick response fund, and they are saying that it will only last for like 10 to or for 15 to 20 days. So that's why they are asking for help from the national government and other non-government organizations for that matter.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Jose Carretero.